going to the game or just going to watch it in the pub?
Watch it in the pub.
Oh, go on. Well, you better get going. It's kicking off soon. Anyway. Right, we're now standing at Traitor's Gate, possibly the most famous, possibly the most infamous gate in the world. Again, this was built during the reign of Edward I, as he required a safer and more useful entrance into the tower. Rather than try and go for the narrow, crowded, twisted streets of London, where convoys could be attacked, stores stolen, and prisoners set free, he decided to use the River Thames as a highway. He had a hole punched through the outer defensive wall, so that at high tide, boats could pass through these gates and unload their cargoes in safety. Therefore, this was originally known as the Watergate. But if it was known as the Watergate, how did it become known as Traitor's Gate? Well, that was down to the large numbers of alleged traitors who passed through those grim gates during the Tudor period. Among them, no less than three queens of England: Queen Anne Boleyn, Queen Catherine Howard, and Lady Jane Grey. And high dignitaries of the elder statesmen were no exception. They and many more poor unfortunate souls would have travelled down from their trials at the Guildhall or the Palace of Westminster, passed through these grim gates and climbed these stony steps. Here they'd be met by guards and escorted through the archways and off to their cells to await whatever fate had in store. For some it would be a short journey to their place of execution.